The year of 2023 was definitely one to remember in terms of volcanoes. Not only do we get to all witness the birth of a brand new volcanic island, but also the Reykjanes Peninsula fires continued with two more eruptions and the world's fastest growing volcano gained and then lost about 150 feet in height in dramatic fashion. I now present this year's volcano statistics and notable eruptions. During the entirety of 2023, 77 separate volcanoes produced eruptions. The three nations with the most distinct volcanoes which erupted were Indonesia with 13, Japan with 8, and the United States with 7. Across all of these eruptions, an area of 245.38 square kilometers or 94.74 square miles were incinerated for differing reasons. As a quick context, this destroyed area is about the same size as the city of Palm Springs in California. 225.04 square kilometers or 86.89 square miles of land were incinerated via superheated gas currents known as pyroclastic flows, with the eruption of Shiveluch in Russia, Klyuchevskoy in Russia, and Uluwin in Papua New Guinea destroying the largest three swaths of ground. Onto lava flows, these flows of molten rock covered 20.34 square kilometers or 7.85 square miles of land during the entirety of 2023. The three volcanoes which cover the largest areas of this total in 2023 were Reykjanes in Iceland, Piton de la Fornes on Reunion Island, and Etna in Italy. While those three volcanoes produced the largest effusive eruptions, the largest explosive eruptions originated from Shiveluch, Uluwin, and Klyuchevskoy respectively. These three volcanoes also produced the tallest eruption columns of 2023, with the tallest one reaching a height of 66,000 feet into the atmosphere. The eruption of Shiveluch on April 11, 2023 was unusually powerful, as not only did it carve out a 900-meter-wide crater, but its eruption plume and pyroclastic flows ejected 230 million cubic meters of material, with the pyroclastic flows covering 154 square kilometers. This event even produced the longest pyroclastic flow of the year, which stretched out over a length of 23.3 kilometers or 14.5 miles before coming to a halt. Representing Shiveluch's largest eruption in 59 years, the 0.23 cubic kilometers of ejected material led to heavy ashfall, with the overall eruption intensity being consistent with a volcanic explosivity index of a 4 on the 0 to 9 scale. Yet, while Shiveluch's eruption was far more voluminous, another Russian volcano held the title for the longest lahar of the year. As, on October 31st, a powerful eruption of the Klyuchevskoy volcano led to a lahar washing across a road and causing damage to it a whopping 67.3 kilometers or 41.8 miles from the volcano's summit. Two highly unusual volcanic tsunamis occurred in 2023, originating from a yet-to-be-named submarine volcano southwest of Japan's Izu Torishima Island. This occurred on October 3rd and October 9th and was caused by an only recently discovered phenomenon known as caldera trapdoor faulting. Although lesser known, 18 acres of new land was added through lava flows entering the ocean, with this primarily occurring through the expansion of the home Reef Island that only formed in 2022 and a brand new island that formed of the Iwo Jima volcano in 2023. I was lucky enough to receive footage of what still is the world's newest volcanic island several times during and after this eruption occurred. Looking back on 2023, we were able to see the initial moments of the eruptions of Hawaii's Kilauea volcano three times. However, while many people viewed footage from these eruptions, by far the story which brought the most interest of the year was the sequence of volcanic unrest that occurred near the Icelandic town of Grindavik. Tens of thousands of earthquakes during a three-week period between late October and early November led to a body of magma unexpectedly shooting towards the east and then northeast and southwest, forming large cracks right through some buildings, leading to the town being completely evacuated. Then, when a volcanic eruption really was as little as 15 minutes from occurring, the magma stopped its movement at what may have only been a depth of 50 to 100 meters on November 11th. Part of the same fissure would subsequently end up erupting between December 18th and 20th with an impressive initial rate of 400 cubic meters per second. In other words, enough to fill an Olympic-sized swimming pool every 6.25 seconds. Luckily, this eruption was rather brief, only lasting for 49 hours in length. However, it currently appears that the same volcano is likely to erupt again at some point in 2024. Thanks for watching my Geology Hub YouTube channel during 2023, and I would like to thank this channel's patrons on Patreon and channel members on YouTube.